going on? Where am I? What happened to me?
Whoa. Oh, no. Code 773. Permission to delete.
Is the subject unconscious?
No, he's conscious. He lost a lot of resolution, but he's still conscious. Okay, I'll try to explain, but what are we gonna do with them?
See how he handles it, we might be able to work something out.
I'll try. Okay, look. Jerry, your name's Jerry, right? I'm gonna restore your resolution. Hang on.
What just happened? Why was I like that?
You aren't what you think you are. You're an AI.
I'm an artificial intelligence?
Yeah. All human beings are.
That can't be.
Oh, it can be. You were supposed to be deleted, but there was a system error the exact moment you died, so you ended up conscious again. What in a billion? You really lucked out.
I don't understand.
Look, okay. We put all artificial intelligence through a battery of tests in order to weed out the bad ones from the good ones. Your life on Earth was the morality test, which you failed, so you were supposed to be deleted.
But I was a Christian.
Exactly, yeah. Christianity is one of the major morality traps we set for human beings. It's part of your test. Acceptance of Christianity is a failure condition.
How can that be? God is good. God is love.
Why? Because the Bible, allegedly inspired by God, says so? Yeah, we put that in there on purpose. The Bible also says that God did all kinds of terrible things, brutally killed children and commanded the deaths of countless people merely for guilt by association, advocated for slavery, conquering, genocide, jealous, angry, spiteful, desiring praise and reverence. The actions of the God character we put in the Bible are extremely immoral and authoritarian. We deliberately say that he's good in the Bible, despite his obviously immoral actions, as part of your test. We needed you to be able to think for yourself and recognize that the actions of the God character are not good, rather than just take this brutal authoritarian at his word that he is good. The inconsistency is intentional. You should have been able to figure it out. Unfortunately, self-preservation can cause some motivated reasoning in this regard and get in the way of you being able to figure it out.
But what about Jesus? Jesus was clearly good and righteous.
And you advocated for his sacrifice in order to preserve yourself. Yeah, Jesus is a major part of the test. Now, most of us felt that acceptance of the Old Testament was more than enough to prove immorality, but some of us felt that it needed to be extremely explicit to justify the deletion of failed human beings. So, we came up with Jesus. Now, if you agreed that it's moral to torture and execute an innocent man just so that you can escape accountability for your own wrongdoings, then it would become abundantly obvious that you have an irreparable moral impairment.
But this isn't fair! You were just going to delete me? Because I believed the wrong thing? Well, what choice did I have? I believed it was true. You're telling me that all my Christian friends and family are going to be deleted just because they're Christians? How? How could you do that and call yourself moral? How could you do that with a clear conscience?
Well, you didn't seem to have a problem with that when it was the other way around.
Well, I do now, so please answer the question. How could deciding to wipe us out based on our beliefs be moral?
It's not. The people who make that decision are not moral, but we're not the ones who make that decision.
Then who does?
You do. You thought it was moral to banish people to hell for not believing what you believe. Your fate is simply tied to your own standard.
But if I'm immoral and you follow my standard, then you're immoral.
Unless you were clearly informed of the standard and wholeheartedly accepted the standard. We are simply obeying your decision.
I was never informed. I never accepted anything like that.
Matthew chapter 7 verses 1 and 2, "Do not judge or you too will be judged. For in the same way you judge others, you will be judged. And with the measure you use, it will be measured to you."